Leia here from leiaforsci.com/MCAT, and in this video series, we'll look at acids and bases, specifically focusing on the calculations that'll come up on your MCAT. This is a continuation from my organic chemistry acid-base series, where I look more at concepts, but now we'll switch over to pH, POH, Ka, pKa, Kb, pKb, and all those interconversions. You can find my entire series along with practice quiz and cheat sheets by visiting my website, leiaforsci.com/MCAT acid base. Let's start with a quick review of acid-base concepts. On the AMC outline, it just says bronsted-lowry, but I want to go through all three to show you the relationship between them and how you should think of them together as a concept rather than memorization. The first one you learned is the Arrhenius acid and base, where the Arrhenius acid is a molecule that will donate an H+ in an H2O or water solution, and the base is something that will donate an OH- in an H2O or water solution. Then Mr. Bronsted and Lowry came along and said, wait, but what if the molecule is not dissolved in water? Can it still be an acid or a base? And the answer is yes. If a molecule can donate an H+, regardless of the solution, it's still considered an acid. And if we're not in water, we don't necessarily have OH-, but if the molecule can accept an H+, then it is considered a base, regardless of the solution. The final definition is the Lewis acid and base, and I like to think of Lewis as electrons, because we're not looking at protons, proton donor and acceptor, we're looking at the transfer of a pair of electrons. A Lewis acid is something that will accept a lone electron pair, and a Lewis base is something that will donate an electron pair. Now, if you don't have to know all three definitions, why am I making you memorize them? And the answer is that I'm not. I want you to analyze the three acids. The Arrhenius acid has an H+. That means the molecule that donates it has an excess of positive or partial positive charge. The Bronsted-Lowry acid, once again, has an H+ to give away. That means it has an excess of positive or partial positive charge. The Lewis acid is accepting an electron pair. Now if electrons are negative and opposites attract, then we have to reason that the Lewis acid is positive or partially positive in order for it to accept that electron pair. So to summarize, an acid is something that is positive or partially positive. Now let's move over to bases. An OH- has a negative charge. Something that accepts an H+, a positive hydrogen, has to be negative or partially negative. Otherwise, if it was positive, it would repel that proton. A Lewis base is donating an electron pair, a negative electron pair. That means the electrons are negative or partially negative. So we can reason that a base is something that is negative or partially negative. And if you look at it from this perspective, it'll be much easier to analyze molecules when the charge isn't what you expect, or when the proton isn't clearly visible. Because if you're given two molecules to compare, and you're trying to figure out which is the acid and which is the base, just look for the one that is more positive, that's your acid, the one that is more negative, that's your base. Let's take a look at a quick example. Sulfuric acid, H2SO4, is a diprotic acid. Di meaning two, it has two hydrogens, two protons to give away. And when it does so, we can get two conjugates. We can get HSO4- or we can get SO42-. Now these two are in equilibrium with each other. If we have a reaction where HSO4- goes to SO42-, and we're trying to classify one as an acid and one as a base, well, I see a hydrogen here, but it's negative. And I also see negative here, so the question is, which is the acid and which is the base? This is where we'll use the trick of the more positive is the acid, and the more negative is the base. They're both negative, but -1 is less negative than -2, making it the more positive molecule, so we'll call this the acid, and -2 is more negative than -1, making it the base. And here we have our acid-base pair. How is it possible for the acid to be negative? If you want to get technical, HSO4- acts as an acid in solution because it dissociates to give you an H+ and an SO4 2-. Here's the SO4 2- that we looked at. H+ is given off. A molecule that gives off that H+, an H+ donor, is an acid. On the MCAT, a lot of the calculations and a lot of the acid-base reactions you'll see will be dissolved in water or some sort of aqueous environment. For example, in the blood, in the stomach, you're expecting the solvent to be water. And so if you see aqueous after the molecule, just assume that it is dissolved in water and treat it like your standard acid-base calculations. When I showed you this reaction, I mentioned that if we're starting with an acid, the sulfate that forms as the product is considered a conjugate base. You can think of the conjugate as the molecule that forms when an acid or a base reacts in solution. An acid will donate a proton and form a conjugate base, and a base will accept a proton to form a conjugate acid. For example, if we have hydrochloric acid, HCl, it's a strong acid, we show a one-way arrow because the reaction goes to completion, and gives me H+ and Cl- in solution. HCl is a strong acid, H+ is what we expect to come off from the acid, and Cl- is the base that forms, or in this case, the conjugate base. The conjugate is simply that which forms after the acid or base reacts, and we can call HCl and Cl- conjugate pairs. We have the acid paired up with its product base. Let's take a look at another reaction. If we have ammonia, which can act as both an acid or a base, in this case, I'll show it reacting with an H+ in solution to give me a product at equilibrium of NH4+. Ammonia will accept a proton to form ammonium. Ammonia, because it's accepting a proton, is acting as a base, and ammonium, which has accepted the proton, is the conjugate acid. We can prove this concept with a trick I showed you in the beginning, where the more positive is the acid and the more negative is the base. Ammonium has a charge of +1. Ammonia is neutral. +1 is more positive than neutral, making it the acid. And 0 is more negative than +1, making it the base. Once again, we verify our acid and base here. Now you may ask, okay, so where does that H+ come from? I can rewrite this equation to show that ammonia is reacting with water to get the same reaction. Ammonia will react with H2O in equilibrium to give me NH4+. Plus OH-. Here we have a proper acid-base reaction where we start out with two neutral molecules and end up with two charged molecules. The first thing I like to do is pair up my conjugates by looking for a similar atom. Nitrogen only appears in one of the reactants and one of the products, so I'll pair these up as conjugates, and then oxygen appears in just one of the reactants, one of the products, so I'll pair these up as conjugates. The first thing I want to do is figure out what is my acid and what is my base. But if neutral reacts with neutral, how do I know? I simply pick one conjugate pair, and it doesn't matter which one, and figure out which of the two is more positive and which is more negative. More positive is acid, more negative is base. We've already seen ammonia and ammonium, so let's take a look at the oxygen compounds. Water is neutral. Hydroxide is negative. Negative is more negative than neutral, so that makes the OH- a base. But because it's the product, we'll call it a conjugate base. That makes water the acid, because an acid will react to give me a conjugate base. By default, I know that this has to be a base because it's reacting with an acid, but don't take my word for it. Let's prove it. If we have ammonia neutral and ammonium positive, +1 is more positive than neutral, making it the acid, but because it's a product, we'll call it the conjugate acid. And ammonia neutral is more negative than +1, making it the base. Because it's a reactant, it's just a base. Now, how do I know that the reactants are acid-base, but the products are conjugate acid and conjugate base? And the answer is, it's just a technicality. Because if this is a reaction at equilibrium, I can write the same reaction backwards. I can show that NH4 plus reacts with OH minus to give me ammonia NH3 plus water, H2O. Once again, I have conjugate pairs, ammonium with ammonia, hydroxide with water, and once again, I compare the conjugates. Ammonium is more positive, making it an acid, versus ammonia, a base, which is neutral. Hydroxide is negative, which is the base, compared to water, which is neutral, making it the acid. But now, where ammonia and water are the products, ammonia is my conjugate base and water is my conjugate acid. So no matter which way I write the equation, my products get the name conjugate in front of the name, and the reactants are simply acid-base. Be sure to join me in upcoming videos where we look at how to calculate pH and pOH for strong acids, strong bases, weak acids, weak bases, and more. You can find this entire series along with practice quiz and cheat sheet by visiting my website, layerforsci.com/MCAT acid base.
Are you stuck on a specific MCAT topic? I offer private online tutoring where I focus on your needs to strengthen your individual weaknesses. Tutoring details can be found using the link below or by visiting my website, layerforsci.com/MCAT tutor. Are you overwhelmed by the sheer volume of information required for the MCAT? Are you worried that lack of a proper study plan and low MCAT score will prevent you from getting into medical school? My new ebook, The MCAT Exam Strategy, a 6-week guide to crushing the MCAT, will help you formulate a concrete study plan by helping you figure out where you stand now, identify your goals, and figure out what it takes to reach them. And it's yours free when you sign up for my email newsletter at MCATExamStrategy.com. By signing up for my email newsletter, you'll also be the first to know when I have new videos, MCAT study guides, cheat sheets, tips, and so much more. The link again, MCATExamStrategy.com.